Okay, we've unboxed the Uponor AquaPort. We've disassembled it from the cabinet and we're ready for installation. As you can see, there's a 2x6 wall here. It's the minimum requirement for installation along with being 16 inches on center. The valves have been disassembled from the AquaPort and they've been installed so the air test could be completed. Now we're ready to put in the wall cabinet. Once you have it at the right height, you're ready for using the attachment hardware that comes in the bag, and that can be screwed to the studs. As you will notice, the sheetrock's been cut away. Typically, this will not be in place, but in case it has, you need to leave access to be able to get the lip that'll sit tight against the stud or the frame. Now that the cabinet's installed in the wall, we're ready to put the AquaPort panel in. Before we do, let's talk about the valves for a second. The valves were installed during the rough-in process in order to have an air test completed. The valves are removed from the original AquaPort packaging. And should have been put in this bag for reinstallation. Very important that these need to go back in before it gets connected up to the valves. Now we'll install the AquaPort. One important tip before tightening up the screws on the back plate is to lift the panel up and tighten it up in an elevated position to make room to install the gaskets. Now that we've secured the AquaPort to the panel and the cabinet, we've tightened up our system connections, we're ready to go to the purge and fill. One tip before we do, before you put on the cabinet and the door, what you want to make sure is the sheetrock is installed before installing those two components. The important thing to remember is you fill on the heating side of this unit, you have to open up a hot tap due to the proportional control valve to allow heating water to go through the heat exchanger. Okay, now we're ready to start the purge process. First thing we'll do is open up the valves on the plumbing side. Key thing to know is to get the air out of the cold water, open up the taps, and over time, a little bit of time, that'll actually get the air out of it. We'll leave the return valve on the hydronic side closed and open up the supply. Next, what we do is we attach the purge hose to the return line to the drain assembly. Once the hose is connected, we can open up the drain line and allow the hydronic system pressure to begin purging air through the supply side, through the air heat exchanger, and out through the return drain valve. If needed, to make sure you get all the air out, the upper valve can be opened, along with the lower valve to make sure any entrained air is removed from the system. Once we have a steady stream of water in the bucket, we can close the valve, make sure our vents are closed, remove our drain line, open up the hydronic return line, and the port is ready for operation. One additional thing, there's a bag that comes with the AquaPort. These are your spare screens and flow restrictors if needed, and make sure you install it on the return line of the heating hydronic water. Now we're ready to install the door and the trim ring. Remember, it needs to be sheetrocked up to the corners of the edges of the AquaPort panel before the door can be installed, but for this purpose, we'll go through the installation. Remove the door. Again, don't forget to document your settings. Fold out the wings for installation. Install the trim ring. Install the door. Always orientate the frame with the fingers on the bottom to hold the door. Lock the panel, and that completes the installation of the Uponor AquaPort.